Hi everyone, I'm Devin and welcome to another episode in the Google Ads API authorization and authentication series. In this episode, I'm going to walk through the desktop app authentication flow using REST. Let's start with some fun. I'm going to go from zero to request or walk through the entire OAuth flow and make a request in under 20 seconds just using my terminal. Afterwards, I'll walk through what I did so you understand each of the steps. Ready? Go. Well, that was fun. Quick reminder before we break down what we just did. If you're enjoying this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. In addition, feel free to drop us a comment below to let us know how this worked out for you and share what types of videos you'd like to see in the future. Finally, just a heads up that all of the code used in this video is linked in the description. Alright, let's walk through those steps a little more slowly to break it down for you. As a quick side note, if you've ever used the authenticate in desktop application example in one of our client libraries, what I'm about to explain is more or less what's going on behind the scenes. The first command I use simply opens up a browser window so that I can step through the authentication flow to generate an access code. You may notice that I have some environment variables set. The first is client ID. We'll also cover client secret and developer token in just a bit. If you need a refresher on any of the credentials used in this episode or how to generate them, check out some of the earlier episodes in this series. The second variable I used was redirect URI. Okay, I maybe cheated a little bit by setting all of these ahead of time. The redirect URI you see here is what you'll use whenever using the desktop application flow, because it tells Google's authorization server to return the authorization code in the browser's title bar. If you were using the web app flow, you would use the actual URI of your application, which users would be redirected back to after authenticating, and you'd programmatically pass the code received in this step to the application to complete the authentication process. Since we're using the desktop app flow, we are redirected to the page that provides us with the code to copy so that we can complete the remaining steps. Without going too much deeper into this topic, the key takeaway here is to use this redirect URI with the desktop application flow. The last thing I want to point out is the scope parameter, which is set to the AdWords scope because we're granting access to the Google Ads API. Let's do that once more. As you saw earlier, this generated an access code, which we used to generate access and refresh tokens. So we save the code in a variable named code. Next, I ran this command to generate an access token. In doing so, I parsed the access token from the response and saved it to a variable called access token, all in one step. Here is the raw curl request against the Google OAuth endpoint to get an access token. Here you can see we make use of some environment variables again, including the access code which we just received. One thing I want to point out here is that the parameters in this post request must all be in a single line without any spaces. If they aren't, you may receive an invalid grant error. When I run the command this way, you can see this gives me an access token, which I used in the following step to make an API request. However, I'm going to pause here to point something out. In this response, I've also received a refresh token. With this refresh token, I no longer have to go through this entire process in the future. I can simply use that refresh token to generate new access tokens because, as you might remember, access tokens are short-lived credentials. This is the suggested approach. Next, we'll save the access token environment variable. And using the REST API, I can make a searchStream request. I'll set my query and make the request. As you can imagine, I make a lot of search requests, so I have a few bash scripts in my terminal using the commands from earlier to generate new access tokens and perform search requests.
As you can see, I can easily generate a new access token with this command. For reference, here is the script I wrote. And using this script, I can easily make search, or rather, search stream requests. Again, here's the script I wrote for this. Although we recommend using one of our client libraries to integrate with the Google Ads API, this is great for making quick API calls, debugging, and troubleshooting directly from the command line.
That's it for this episode. I hope you found this useful. From the Google Ads API team, see you next time.